Hola juego amigos, ahora estamos en vivo aquí a través de YouTube para poder platicar con ustedes, ¿no es cierto? Vamos a mostrarles lo que estamos experimentando ahora en el stand de Marvel, de Mattel. Estamos en Mattel ahora y pues vengan a dar el recorrido, disculpen ustedes, pero es muy temprano para mí. Y bueno, pues vamos a comenzar con primero una de las propiedades más importantes que van a tener durante este año, que es Mujer Maravilla. Y aquí estamos viendo el traje de Gal Gadot, que es la... Bueno, esa es una de las réplicas que están circulando por todo el mundo. Y bueno, aquí lo pueden ver. Y aquí está acompañando la línea de muñecas Barbie, de Mujer Maravilla, que podemos ver que ahora han mejorado un poco el detalle de la escultura, con sobre todo en la cara, y el vestuario en tela es bastante llamativo. También el caballo tiene muchos puntos a favor. Perfecto, aquí tenemos otra, bueno, arriba están los jugables, los que serían los artículos para sentirse como parte de el personaje. Tenemos el arco, allá al fondo está la tiara y la pulsera, y arriba la espada. Y aquí mientras le seguimos mostrando nuevamente a la Mujer Maravilla, que yo creo que esta es la versión deluxe. Aunque bueno, estas otras también se ven bastante impresionantes. Vamos a mostrárselas como debe ser. Tenemos aquí las otras versiones de ella. La escultura es un poco más voluptuosa. Tiene este es el modelo con ropa, que sí es un poco distinto al otro. Aquí están las versiones cuando es amazona. Y esta otra, que es digamos la que sería la línea más económica, está completa, toda la ropa viene como parte del molde. Pero aún así el rostro es muy similar en todas.
This one is the same, that one?
So this is...
A ver, nos están comentando algo.
Muñeca fashion, muñeca feature. Okay. So they have articulated elbows, knees, and wrist, so they can move. And then these are doll con caballo together. And then this is Wonder Woman's madre, and it's doll and caballo together. Well, and then these are role play.
Will all these be available at retail stores, or there's one exclusive over here?
Retail stores, yes. Yes.
There's no Comic-Con exclusive or...
Not as of yet. No, these will be available in June. The movie is in June. Wonder Woman, the feature. So these will come out before the feature.
Okay.
Yes, very exciting. And they're also sculpted in the likeness of Gal Gadot. She's our title character. She is playing Wonder Woman. So, yeah, they're very beautiful. It's exciting. It'll be an amazing movie.
There's a suggested retail price now on this?
I have the prices, yes. The fashion dolls are $14.99. The feature dolls are $19.99. Wonder Woman and her Black Stallion, $29.99 together. And this is Queen Hippolyta, of course. Wonder Woman's mother and the Stallion are $29.99 together. And the role play items range from $9.99 to $24.99.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much.
Bueno, pues ya lo vieron. Este es el nuevo rango de las muñecas que van a estar acá. Y ahora, pues pasando a otra de las propiedades, pues tenemos a la Liga de la Justicia, y nos están presentando en estos momentos el nuevo Batmobile.
Do you guys want to see it work?
Yes. Nos están preguntando si queremos ver cómo funciona el nuevo Batimóvil, que es una cosa impresionante.
Ready?
We're ready.
Okay.
Estamos listos.
So this is the 1:10 scale version. of the Justice League Batmobile. Batman will be driving in the new Justice League movie. New features that he'll have in the car will be the rocket launchers, the twin Gatling guns, and a massive anti-aircraft cannon on the side. So I'll run you through the features. We'll start it up. The sound is proportional to the throttle. So is the exhaust. The car itself can lift itself 2 inches off the backside for the height change. The real Batmobile actually has the ability to raise its height by 2 feet, so it's scale to scale. We'll go down to the front of the car. The steering, the Gatling guns, and the rocket launcher are all linked together, so when I steer the wheel, it's all track left and right. The actual Gatling guns are alive. Go inside the car. Inside the car is actually Batman in there. That's a true 6-inch action figure that does come with the car. It won't be that one per se, but it will be one more directly tied to the movie. But Batman actually steers the car. The dashboard on the car is actually interactive as well. The dashboard will have interactive lights. The faster you go, the brighter the flashes get. When you stop, the lights get really, really bright. So I'll go back open again. Underneath the roll cage is a FPV camera. So in the end, I'm not controlling it with this big controller. You'll be controlling it with your iPhone, or let's just say phone per se, tablet, whatever. Yeah, a smartphone or a device. Once you download the app, you'll have full control of this vehicle. But with that, we do some special effects. Because we know where the gun is, where this cannon is, and that rocket launcher, I can track that movement with that camera and the software. So we'll give you real live muzzle flashes coming out of the Gatling guns that are tracked left and right. The user will see the back of this rocket launcher and will be able to launch virtual rockets off, augmented rockets, and blow up in the distance. When the cannon is lifted back and shoots its massive artillery shell, the actual shutter on the actual image on your camera will shake. 2 seconds later, down in the distance, you'll see a massive explosion. And so not only is it alive on the outside, you have Batman driving the car, but you get the user the full movie experience, what it's like to shoot the guns, shoot the cannon, and be Batman with this Justice League Batmobile.
This one, when's going to be available?
Pre-sales will be during Comic-Con. There'll be a big, huge booth and a showing. It hits store shelves in October and right before movie release, November.
And about retail suggested price?
It's going to be $250.
Now you have a little bit version.
No, this is actually, so this is the model that I built. This is production level model. So size to size, it hasn't gotten any different except this is more true to scale. So this is what the consumer will be getting. It has every function that this one has, moving guns, rocket launchers, cannon, actually moves separately from the other guns. The 6-inch Batman will be able to fit inside, like so. There's a Wi-Fi camera underneath the roll cage. The height change is also there. The car can raise and lower itself with all that amazing sound this had, and will also blow smoke.
How much is weight?
About 4 to 5 pounds.
Ya lo vieron, está grandote, pero está unos 3 kilos, más o menos, y está interesante. Thank you very much.
Very much.
Y bueno, ahora pasamos a la serie de Justice League Action, donde tenemos nuevas figuras, un nuevo modelaje en cuanto a los personajes. Podemos ver cómo se inspiraron en varios formatos. Digo, el Joker estaba más inspirado en la serie de Batman The Animated Series, pero Mujer Maravilla está inspirada en el vestuario que está usando Gal Gadot en la película, y sin embargo Superman está más inspirado en el cómic, y Batman en la serie de cómics que hiciera Frank Miller con Batman Año 1. Muy interesante cómo hicieron todas las nuevas figuras de Superman y bueno, de todos esos superhéroes. Y ahora tenemos nuevas versiones un poco más grandes, los nuevos 12 pulgadas de Justice League para, pues ahora sí que para todos los públicos. Y tenemos nueva línea de Teen Titans Go. Que Teen Titans Go, mira, aquí está la base coleccionador.
con todo y su auto. Y tenemos estas nuevas figuras en tamaño de unas 2 pulgadas, 2 pulgadas y media. Y también hay figuras un poquito más grandes. Este niño bestia parece que tiene cierta movilidad, pero ahora sí que aquí no hay quien nos explique. Pero son de los nuevos. Y bueno, vamos a cambiar a una de las nuevas series de Nickelodeon que se llama Shimmer and Shine. Las Teeny Genies, o sea, las pequeñas genio. Entonces tenemos nuevos playsets que parecen ensamblajes con blocks.
Mega blocks.
Y bueno, obviamente estos son mega blocks. Pero las figuras están un poco más grandes para hacer mega blocks. Y aquí está por lo que sería la figura de línea normal. Este sería el palacio coleccionador. Y las figuras que están aquí también las tenemos puestas. Esta es la colección completa y seguramente se venderán como en estas botellas, porque finalmente son genios, salen de sus botellas o sus lámparas, y ahí atrás están las distintas presentaciones. Aquí tenemos versiones un poco más grandes en vinil. Figuras de 6 pulgadas. Y aquí están las figuras de 10 pulgadas. Does this have movement? Bueno, van a preguntar sobre estas. Estas parece ser que se mueven. Tienen alguna funcionalidad ahí con... Porque parece que tienen un movimiento acá lindo. Claro. Does this have movement? Ok. They are articulated. Ok, están perfectamente articuladas estas pequeñas. Y bueno, aquí está toda la línea de la serie. Thank you. Y ahora vamos con Blaze de Nickelodeon and the Monster Machine. Los Wild Wheels. Y, well, can you tell us something about Wild Wheels?
Absolutely. So, Blaze continues to be the number one show for preschool boys ages 2 to 5 on television across all TV. The iTunes apps appeared at number one on the iTunes store for kids. Top of the World game is the best performing game on NickJr.com. It's just been greenlit for season 4. And, of course, we're really excited to continue to bring the content to life. For the spring, we have the Light Riders Temple series. The Hyperloop here is the spring TV driver. And for the fall, we have Wild Wheels. So Blaze and his friends are going to go visit Animal Island and transform into animals because, of course, it's all about the monster moves, the monster trucks, and the monster transformations. And we know that little boys love the animals, the jungle, and the racing. We have the die-cast vehicle assortment here, which is our top performer. We have 6 vehicles that are Animal Island themed. So we have Eagle, Blaze here. We've got Super Stripes, Cheetah Crusher. We've got Squirrel Darrington, Elephant Starla, and Shark Blaze. And then we have 3 new characters who are appearing in the line for the first time: Bump Bumperman, Smashy, and King Truck. So that brings a total, those 9 vehicles bring the total to 44, so quite a lot in the collection. Highly collectible. They all work with all the track sets. We're actually looking at 3 different track sets combined together here. And our spring TV driver here is the Animal Island Stunt Speedway. So we're bringing Animal Island to life here. It comes with an exclusive Lion Blaze die-cast vehicle. And there's 4 different stunts and jumps. So right now she's putting the vehicle through the hidden S-shaped curve of the cave track. So Blaze actually goes upside down through that curve. We've also got the cliff drop that he's about to go over there. So that's the cliff drop. And we have, let's see the cliff drop there. Woo! And then there's the tumbling tree track and also the roaring falls. So you put the, there you go, so we got the tumbling tree track there. Whoa! And then the Roaring Falls, of course, is the big one on the front there. All right, let's see the Roaring Falls here. Oh, you want to catch the vehicle off the Roaring Falls?
Sure.
All right, I'm going to send him down the Roaring Falls. You got to catch him. Ready? Oh, here we go. Ah! Oh my gosh! There we go. So that's the exclusive Lion Blaze vehicle that comes with the Animal Island set. There's also a room here for Blaze's small animal friends to hide out. So we got the crab there. Those come separately. They can hide out in a little cave there, a little track that they added in for Blaze as well, or for the animal friends, excuse me. Yeah, do you want to get any of those? I can turn it so that you can get them. So we have here, this is the hidden cave track. So Blaze goes upside down through that, over the rickety bridge. Can we get that one again? There we are. And then we've got the one in the back, the cliff drop there. And then we have the tumbling tree track. So these are also bringing some of those STEM concepts to life that are from the show. So we have the inertia of the track, the suspension of the upside down cave curve, and then we have the Roaring Falls here. Gravity defying jump there through the gates off into Animal Island.
That really looks fun.
Yeah, it's gonna come in a huge box. It'll be terrific. See all the different stunts and jumps on the box. And you'll be able to see the Blaze figure on the box as well.
When it's supposed to be available?
No, this is for the fall. Okay. Yeah, so fall 2017, yep. Yeah, and again, that one will be at TV advertised, so. And it'll tie in with the, I think they're still determining exactly how many episodes there will be, but the Wild Wheels, Animal Island will be the content tentpole.
So let's write Santa to get this in Christmas.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Have fun.
Bueno, pues seguimos aquí. Estamos en Toy Fair, en el stand de Mattel. Vamos a seguir el recorrido porque tenemos muchas cosas que presentar y pues aquí hay algo que siempre será importante. Tenemos la línea, tú puedes ser lo que sea de Barbie. Y presentamos las nuevas modelos de Barbie. Bueno, todo lo que están viendo aquí es la línea que se llama You Can Be Anything. Y es la nueva idea de Barbie para realmente darle confianza a las niñas, ¿no? Tú puedes ser una sirena, puedes ser presidente, puedes ser campeona de karate, puedes ser lo que tú quieras. Y es un modelo que ahora Barbie está tratando de impulsar a todas las niñas. Y ahora tenemos de la nueva película de Barbie que se llama Sueñotopía, o bueno, Dreamtopia, tenemos la nueva línea de personajes fantásticos que van a acompañar a Barbie en su aventura y todo lo que conlleva, y las nuevas muñecas de esta misma serie, que son como unas nuevas hadas por ahí. Acá tenemos más el playset del castillo de la misma serie de Dreamtopia. Y ahora hay un nuevo set que es Barbie Aventuras en su casa de ensueño, el Dream House Adventures, que es ahora Barbie tiene su minivan que se vuelve todo un salón de fiestas para todas sus amigas. Y miren, tienen hasta para hacer malvaviscos y toda la cosa. Esto es ahora Barbie Dream Horse, el caballo de ensueño de Barbie. Qué bueno, desde que siempre conocemos a Barbie, siempre ha tenido un interés por los caballos. Y aquí tenemos el Pet Center, que estamos viendo cómo lo andan tomando tus compañeros. Ahora estamos viendo cómo funciona el laboratorio, que tú puedes poner ahí a tu mascota y tienes rayos X para ellos. Y bueno, aquí tenemos la evolución de las muñecas de Barbie. How is this doll evolution line?
Sorry?
How is this evolution line? Can you talk to me?
Yeah, well, actually, what we're looking at right now is our one-of-a-kind dolls. So over here is our YSL, Yves Saint Laurent, dolls, and they were featured in the Seattle Art Museum as part of an exhibition, a collaboration with them. And they were also featured on our Barbie Style Instagram account, which treats Barbie like a social media influencer. It looks through a first-person perspective of Barbie's life. We've been open for had the account for 2 years, and it has almost 2 million followers. And we've had incredible partnerships like with Marc Jacobs and Moschino. And Barbie went to Sundance. She went to the Forbes Women's Summit. She went to the Glamour Women of the Year Awards. So she's a jet-setting woman, and she goes to all the biggest events, and she has fantastic fashion. This is our Gigi Hadid one-of-a-kind doll. She was also featured on our Barbie Style Instagram in conjunction with the release of her Tommy by Gigi line. So she's wearing some of her Tommy Hilfiger fashion looks right now.
So we only get the chance to see them here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And on Instagram?
Yes, and on Instagram.
Okay, now we have this doll evolved.
Yes, so these are our 2017 Fashionista dolls. And so in 2016, you might remember, we launched our four body types in Barbie.
Yes.
Curvy, tall, petite, and original. And we are continuing forward with our commitment to diversity and variety because it has done extremely well for the brand. These dolls were named one of Time Magazine's 25 Best Inventions of 2016. And she also won Doll of the Year at the Toy of the Year Awards. Yeah. So they're really, really doing well for the brand. In this 2017 line, we have 11 different skin tones, 21 different hair colors, a wide variety of facial sculpts and eye colors. So we're really just seeing a lot more detail and variety. And of course, on trend fashion elements like bold prints and statement stripes and top knots in their hair. So just keeping everything really fresh and trend relevant.
Yeah, well, I got a mad, I might add, we are from Mexico.
Oh, okay.
And the line, the change in Barbie was very well received over there.
Was it?
They love the idea of having a different kind of body in Barbie, and they
awesome.
Loved it.
Awesome. And that makes me so happy. I mean, the world seems to love it because it's doing really well. And it's just great for Barbie to reflect the world that we live in today.
Yeah. Yeah. So. This one and the You Can Be Whatever You Want, mm-hmm. that's, I think, it's a great... and positive messages coming out from Barbie.
It is. It's become a billboard statement for the brand.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Y ahora tenemos las muñecas de Barbie on the go, que estas ya son plástico un poquito más pequeño. Que es... Yeah, ahí hay un caballo que tiene Bueno, vamos a colarnos por aquí. Hi. Can you talk to me about Barbie on the go? What is?
So this is a brand new segment. I'm just going to walk around a little bit and set up some of the triggers for you so you can see the extent of it. This is the first time ever we're introducing our brand new motorized vehicles and ponies within the Barbie line. We're very excited about it. It's really broadening our portfolio, especially toward our younger girls. So this is geared toward ages 3 to 6. And it also introduces a new system of play that includes tracks, which we've also never had in Barbie before. It's very collectible. You can see we have ponies, convertibles, and scooters. And we also are introducing our new 3-inch scale of Barbie. She's got a bobblehead. Head so she can bob along there, and articulated legs. She's very diverse as well. She comes in different skin tones and hairstyles and hair colors and fashions. And here you can see 5 different play sets all built together with our beautiful Barbie track that really expresses Barbie's personality well. So it's bright pink and green, very sparkly and translucent. And all of the track pieces you can snap together and apart and recreate your own track system. You can also see they have fun triggers, so Barbie's a great driver. She knocks over stop signs and trees all along the way, so it's very humorous as well. Yeah, we're really excited about it. And the pieces are all battery operated, so it takes a single AAA battery, very easy to load and unload, and it allows for 4 hours of continuous play.
So how and the figures are sold already sold separately, but the tracks, how is the set? I mean, how long is the set? You mm-hmm. said you have three here, but you know.
Well, it's five track sets five here. Tracks. Yeah, so we have several track pieces that come with each playset. So for example, our price points are 20, 30, and 40 for each of our playsets. And our 20 playsets would come with 8 track pieces and 6 triggers, as well as a doll and vehicle or a doll and pony. But you can also buy the doll and vehicle or doll and pony separately. And also, if you want to get more dolls, you can get those separately as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Just so you know, they'll be coming out in stores about November this year.
Mm-hmm. Bueno, casi todo esto va a ser una línea que vamos a tener lista para fall, para diciembre, para que pidan a los reyes o a Santa o a quien quieran. Pero esto va a estar disponible a partir de noviembre. Y bueno, ahora pasamos de Barbie a otra de las propiedades más importantes de Mattel, que se llama Hot Wheels. Y entonces estamos viendo... Bueno, este display es impresionante. No sé qué tanto se alcance a definir en la pantalla, pero estamos viendo carritos, carritos y más carritos de Hot Wheels. Y bueno, la tradición de... Hay mucha historia en esas pantallas también. Están viendo los track builders y... ¡Wow! ¿Qué líneas? Pero bueno, vamos a enfocarnos a esta nueva serie que se llama Hot Wheels Design. Que esto tiene... mira, aquí hay una tableta de felicitaciones a Mattel por ser el juguete más vendido en los Estados Unidos. Y esta es la nueva serie para el 2017. Acá podrán verla antes para saber qué es lo que pueden ir a buscar después en sus tiendas de preferencia. Y tenemos aquí de la serie Marvel... las nuevas figuras de inspiradas en personajes de Marvel, en Spider-Man Homecoming, está Capitán América, Iron Man, pero aquí están los Guardianes de la Galaxia Volumen 2. Podemos verlos en paques y aquí están los carros sueltos. Ese es, por ejemplo, el carro que está basado en Star-Lord. Y aquí está toda la línea Marvel, porque aquí podemos ver tres en sus blisters, pero aquí está inclusive Hulk y Punisher, que no están aquí en sus... En los blisters, ¿no? Y aquí se pueden ver algunos de los dibujos de diseño de producción. Y ahora tenemos en la línea Star Wars, pues nuevos vehículos, nuevos carros inspirados en Rogue One, que están ahí para que ustedes los vean, basados en todos los personajes, basados en K2, en el Stormtrooper, en Jean Erso y en las naves. Esta línea de Hot Wheels se está volviendo muy, muy, muy importante. Y obviamente aquí no va a haber una revelación de episodio 8, pero estaremos esperando episodio 8 a finales de año. Y ahora tenemos nuevos vehículos de DC Comics con imágenes más parecidas a los de la película. Se parece más a Jim Caviezel. Y así son las nuevas figuras de los superhéroes. Y este vehículo de Superman se parece mucho al que le habían diseñado en los 90 a la serie de televisión. Y ahora tenemos nuevos vehículos de DC Superhero Girls. Estas niñas que van a tener su aparición ahora ya en Hot Wheels. Y ahí están los carritos sueltos. Y más pistas. Pistas. Esta se ve que debe estar muy buena. Va a estar corriendo por todos lados. Mira, pues es para tener bien puesto en toda la casa esto. Bueno, un saludo a todos los que nos están viendo en esos momentos. Muchas gracias por su sintonía. Estamos, les repito, en vivo a través de YouTube. Desde Toy Fair estamos visitando el booth de Mattel, que está presentando todo lo nuevo que tienen en la línea, bueno, no todo, sino la mayor cantidad de cosas que nos pueden mostrar. Y aquí tenemos algunas pistas ya construidas, las nuevas líneas de las track builders. Que bueno, como siempre, son pistas que asemejan la realidad y que hacen que tus carros
vuelen y corran y tengan una de las mejores opciones para que te puedas divertir y entretener con ellas. Nada más, ese es un gran set. Y parece que vamos a tener una demostración. Ok.
Ooh, what a bridge. Bring the bridge back together. That was terrible. Oh, humanity.
Ok, vamos a tener una segunda prueba.
I kind of like that. In slow motion, that would be kind of fun.
This is great.
Here we go. Oh, yes, baby. We're flying now. So the idea is once you cross the bridge, there's a funnel action. One car is going to get knocked into second place. So here we go. Oh, there, he's first. The other guy's hanging on for second. Loser. Yeah.
Bueno, se supone que aquí, en esta parte, ambos carros convergen y uno es el que sale volando y el otro es el que continúa, con la... Oh, y ahí tenemos un puente para que puedan tener un salto. Oh. Y verán cómo son divertidas. Ahí va.
¡Woohoo!
Ahí está, muy bien. El carro, wow.
In any language, cool.
Yeah. Totalmente.
I can show you. Come on over here. I'll show you a little
more. Nos van a mostrar otro lanzamiento.
Let me grab a car. I'm going to kind of launch this here. You can follow this car up to the elevator.
Okay. Lo puedes ver. Bueno, vamos a ver pasar por todos los elevadores.
There we go. So I'm going to launch these guys. You ready?
Okay. Wow. Eso está muy bueno. Excelente. Well, thank you very much. Bueno, pues ahora estamos yéndonos, digamos, de primero del lado izquierdo y después vamos a regresar para que vean lo que para nosotros es el lado derecho, porque ahora tenemos la línea de Thomas and Friends. Wow, no, pero antes está Imaginex. Wow, órale. Este es basado en la película La Momia. The Mummy, this is a film, right?
Well, this is actually our new non-licensed segment, but as you can see, you know, it's like, you know, the Mummy segment, Indiana Jones, things like that, that treasure hunter idea. And so we got our intrepid explorers here, and they're going up against the mummies, and it's all to try and get the treasure of the scarab. And perhaps it's hiding inside our beautiful serpent strike pyramid that you see here. And we have all kinds of features, like when our explorer crosses the rickety bridge, you could turn this power pad, boulders come by, knock out the bridge, turn this one right here, opens up the face of the pharaoh, it reveals the giant serpent, but the mummy king, the serpent king here, presses down on his power pad, serpent strike, grabs the explorer, pulls him into the temple. What's going to happen next? I don't know, it's up to kids.
Wow.
Yeah, so we got 360 degrees of play, you can play in the front or the back, trap doors, dungeons, lights and sounds, even a voice changing microphone, so everything you need to tell whatever story you can imagine.
Yeah, the classic Masters of the Universe, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Another fine Mattel product.
Now, you have here a new Batman suit?
Absolutely. So what this is, the Batbot Extreme. Obviously, here at Imaginex, we love Batman. This guy stands 2 feet tall, so it's nearly as tall as the kids are going to be playing with him. And, of course, you turn the power pads, and it makes the magic start. For instance, open up the chest, lights and sounds. You show the headquarters. Batman can then take the elevator up into the cockpit, where he can now fight crime. Fire projectiles from the missile launchers at a push of the button, or you go down here to the foot, turn the power pad here, Bat Cycle launches into action. But the most impressive thing happens when you turn this power pad. Bat wings pop out, super punching fists spring into action. Turn it to the side so you can see, pull the trigger, activate that punching. You can also take the bat disc projectiles, put those into the fists, and those will fling out when you punch. Last but not least, press the button on the back. Voice changing microphone. How awesome is that?
It's awesome. What is for me? And
yeah, I always say when people say, what's the age demographic? 3 to 43?
Or beyond.
Or beyond, yes. And up.
And this are...
All right, yeah. So this...
RC.
Yes, this is an RC. This is our DC Super Friends RC Mobile Command Center. As you can see, it has lights and sounds, a little voice of the robot there, catchphrases for Batman. So it's a great basic RC vehicle. It'll go forwards and backwards, but the real magic happens when you hit the big button right here on the remote control. Transforms from RC vehicle into playset, missile launchers. You got a little jail here for once you catch the bad guys, but most important, puts the Batwing into launch position. You hit this small button right here and it'll actually launch up to 10 feet. So, you guys ready? Boosh, just like that. Look at that, hitting cameraman everywhere. So as you can see, it's not just an RC truck, but since you can actually manipulate the playset with the remote control, it's also an RC playset.
Okay, great. And now you have other kid favorite, absolutely, Power Ranger, you had Zordon.
Yeah, you know, the movie's coming out here in the spring, so we've got actually a very robust Power Rangers segment here at Imaginext. But this is the playset that came out recently, and that's what we're featuring. Comes with two figures. It comes with the Alpha 5 character right here, also the blue Power Ranger. You have the face of Zordon. You put Alpha 5 in the power pad, turn him, it activates LED lights. The face shimmers. You turn the power pad on the tower right here. Missile launcher pops out. But of course, the Power Rangers have to stay in shape to fight Rita Repulsa. So you got to put your favorite figure in the training harness, hit the tab. Go, go, Power Rangers. That way they can stay in shape and go out there and fight evil.
Awesome. And now you for Mega Construct, you have a new Megazord.
Yeah, and this is our Megazord from Mega Blocks here, Mega Constructs. We just have this over here because we wanted to show people that with the movie coming out, Mattel in general has an incredibly varied and array of toys coming out for every Power Ranger fan out there.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
You got it, man. Take care.
Tenemos una gran línea para todos esos Imaginex, están muy, muy buenos. Y bueno, y para los niños tenemos My First Thomas and Friends, o sea, esos son los primeros acercamientos que puede tener un pequeño con la serie de Thomas and Friends, que estos juguetes están realmente duros. Y si trae este... Ah, thank you. Tienen sonidos, estos son los primeros acercamientos para un niño. This is the first the first Thomas for a kid, right?
Yes, this is my first Thomas. As you can see, it's made for toddlers. It's a little baby version. This train, as well as having the effects on the front buffer, also has these keys at the bottom, and they work with these little activation points that we have on the Railway Pals track system. So you can roll, this is Rosie. We'll roll her along the track here. Mm-hmm. There's 9 different activation points on the set, 10 little details over here for hours of playtime.
Cool. Thank you. And now you have another line with Trackmaster. You please show us.
This is the cable bridge set. It's from the new movie that we have coming out, Journey Beyond Soder. Thomas has left Soder, he's at the Steelworks, and he's about to make a daring escape. He goes up the ramp here, it looks like he's about to fall off, and then just in time, drops down. Right over there, he's saved again. A gear drops down. This is out. It catches the gear, takes it to its rightful spot, and you can recreate the scene over and over again.
Cool. That's cool. Thank you. Bueno, aquí tenemos ya los minis, que estos son favoritos de todos. Nuevas versiones. Siempre hay algo nuevo que mostrar y ahora tenemos nuevas versiones en la figura de los Power Rangers. Y nuevamente con DC Comics tenemos otros nuevos, pero estos de los Power Rangers, los Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, están ahora ya en los minis de Thomas. Qué bonitos están. Y ahora tenemos estos que son Metal Engine.
This is Thomas' Adventures. So this is all about the adventures that Thomas and his friends go on off of Soder. So Thomas will get into trouble with sharks and pirates. He can explore outer space. And in this story, this is the sea monster set. Thomas is out for some pirate treasure. He boards the ship, and all of a sudden a big monster comes out of the ocean and takes it captive. You rock the ship back and forth. Thomas goes up the ramp, comes out safely with the treasure.
It's a busy train.
It is.
And now we have?
This is the shark escape set. So in this story, Thomas is out at sea. There's a storm brewing. He gets into a little bit of trouble. So Harold comes to save the day. He picks him up in a cart, but the winds are a little too strong. And Thomas drops down, does a full 360-degree loop, just barely misses the shark here, and then rolls away to safety. Thomas is always okay.
Yeah, incredible.
This is right now, actually.
Okay. Este ya se puede conseguir en tiendas. Este ya está libre. No, y ahora for Mega Bloks.
Mega Bloks, we've redesigned them with the big maxi block styles. So these are big blocks for little hands. This is the Journey Around Soder set. It has 70 pieces in a bag where you can build three iconic locations. We have Knapford Station, the Steamworks, Marin, and it comes with the buildable Thomas. It's made of five pieces that you can put together. This is the Racin Railway Wagon. You can build the little Tidmouth shed here. Thomas has special little racing decals because this drops down. You can watch him race down the track. And when you're done playing, all the pieces fit inside the wagon. You can just roll it away.
Great. Son de las mejores formas que tienen para los niños. Thank you very much. Yeah. Thomas is a great line.
Yeah.
Y bueno, pues ya, ropa, una cama. La cama de Thomas. Esa no creo que la lleven, pero estará muy buena, ¿no? Y este ya es el set de Amigos en Movimiento que pues combina los que ya nos mostraron, ¿no? Esta del tren con otras que están muy, muy bien. A ver, ¿qué más tenemos de este lado? Creo que ya no hay nada más. No, ya no podemos pasar por ahí, pero ese es Power Wheels. Y vamos a darnos de vuelta ahora con Fisher-Price. Que esto es lo nuevo de Fisher-Price. Que ahora, pues son una bicicleta fija para que los niños puedan ejercitarse mientras ven sus caricaturas favoritas en un iPad o en un tablet. Pues de hecho es una bicicleta fija, o sea, no... Sí, pero bueno, exacto. Aquí está el... Claro, es una aplicación con la que puedes jugar. Y bueno, y así el niño siente que está llevando la carretera. Y aquí tenemos para leer. Yes.
There's a full size version of this in that room out. If come around the corner, I'll come.
Vente.
So if you'd like to try it? Or if someone...
Yeah, why not?
A ver, vamos a probar esta. A ver.
Yeah, just keep get it going and it'll start. Yeah, there you go.
Esta es la versión para niños.
Este
es para nada más para exhibición, pero en una de esas no estaría mal que la hicieran también para adultos. It wouldn't be that bad that it would be made for for adults. Maybe you can play with your kids.
Right.
So it's going to be Amazon.com this?
Amazon.com this fall, and it's available for pre-order today.
Does include the tablet, or you can use your one and
use your own tablet, use your own Amazon Firebox or your own Apple TV box to stream directly to the TV, or you can use the tablet really using technology that's already in the home.
Excelente, eso es para integrar lo que ya tienes en casa con nuevos juegos para tus hijos. Wow.
Great. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. después del ejercicio mañanero. ¿Qué más tenemos por acá? Inspiring little learners to be big thinkers. Esto es para inspirar a los pequeños que aprenden a ser grandes pensadores. Y ahí está el display. Y me voy a colar aquí a la explicación. I'm going to jump in.
All right, let's swing our tails like an alligator. This is a life skill, people. Shaking your tail feather. What's he going to do next? So then he's going to cycle into a different letter of the alphabet. How does an elephant stop? Let's find out. Here he goes. So we've got 360 degrees of mobility and a variety of different movement patterns. He's got three modes of play with two games in each mode. We can play Movi Says, our version of Simon Says. We can play Red Light, Green Light. We can play Tag. Again, all about getting kids up, moving, having fun. But then we have Think and Move Shapes, where we can learn how to create a shape with our body. All right, let's make shapes. Okay, a triangle. Let's do it. And then at the end, he'll ask the child, sailboat is what shape? Press green for triangle. Press red for square. So then I can interact with him via the buttons on the top of his head. And as you can see, he works on all flooring surfaces, including carpeting. He'll be $49.99, and he will be out in the fall.
Thank you. Bueno, pues ya lo vieron. Nuevo juguete interactivo de Fisher-Price, que se ve bastante bueno. A un buen precio, $49.99. Acá tenemos más. Fisher Price. Hi, what do we have here?
Well, we have some really great play sets for the fall of 2017. A couple of our core items are a brand new farm that you see over this way. All of our new play sets have these three buttons that you can press down on that unlock even more fun, like this. They play songs, light up the farmyard, pick our little buddies up. We've got a grain silo that we can turn to get some food going for them. We can actually place these food items in their little stalls so they can eat in privacy. We actually have a discovery button in our chicken coop that you see over this way. Our little baby chicks are about to pop out of the eggs. We have a little bell to let the animals know it's not only time to eat, but maybe time to go to sleep. Our little mama cow and her calf are so sweet, and we can put them to bed under this little soft goods blanket because our Caring for Animals farm is all about nurturing and care, of course. And then everything folds up. There's even more play on the back side, and you can take it on the go with this little carry handle that you see right there. That's our Caring for Animals farm. Cool. We also have a rescue center over here, brand new playset. All of our playsets actually hook together with these little connector pieces. So once you've moved out of the farm, you might move over here to our rescue center, our animal rescue. This is our TV driver for the fall, and it's all about helping others and helping animals. When you press down on the button, the fire truck comes racing out of the building to get the kitty out of the tree. And if he's climbed a little too high, we just crank up our chopper and we can get him out that way as well. And then once he's down, we got to make sure he's healthy, right? So we take him to the vet. There's a little song about caring for animals. Right, and then around the backside, we of course have another little puppy in our adoption center that's waiting for his forever family, and we're scrubbing him up.
When they wag their tails.
He's very happy, he's getting all clean. Yes, he is. And then everything folds up again, and you can take it on the go with the carry handle. And of course, you can also use the connectors to connect to any one of our play sets. And we have one other item. We always have a partnership with our Disney princesses over here in Little People, and this is our Magic Wand Castle. Brand new for the fall, very beautiful, 2.5 feet tall, the biggest castle we've ever had for our Little People princesses. Beautiful picture panels, grand doorway, but look, it's getting to be midnight. We better get inside. All right, what's happening? Oh.
My name Cinderella.
Comes with Cinderella, comes with Rapunzel. There's voice recognition at the bottom of the steps. So whoever you put there is going to have a phrase that relates to that character. Is the best day ever, Rapunzel. Little banners that pop down with our discovery button, 7 different rooms to get ready, but here's the magic. When you press down on the heart button, you bring the castle to life as well. So kids can actually act like a fairy godmother. When we start waving our wand back and forth, ooh, the stairs light up and we're gonna get even more music. It's like they get to create their own little fantasy. And that is our Magic Wand Palace.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for visiting Little People.
Bueno, y eso fue lo que tenía presentado Little People para nosotros. Bueno, estas son las figuras más pequeñas para 6 meses, para 6 meses, para los recién nacidos. Tenemos siempre mucho en... De Fisher Price. Bueno, y aquí hay otras figuras en display. A ver, vénganse ahora para acá. Porque ahora estamos en Mega. Que puede ser Mega Bloks o Mega Construct. Y lo primero que tenemos es Pokémon. Las nuevos megas de Pokémon. Wow, estos sí es nuevo. Y ahí está el Charizard, acá está. Bastante bonito. En la Pokébola tenemos a los Pokémones. Y ahora viene Halo. Bueno, sigan viendo los Pokémones. Mientras nos pasamos a Halo. Con figuras un poquito más detalladas. Si antes ya estaban bonitas, ahora están todavía más bonitas. Y son ensamblables. Aquí podemos ver cómo, de qué forma puedes ensamblarla. Y ahora tenemos de la próxima película, Mi Villano Favorito 3. Los nuevos megas. Con algunos esos que bueno ya los habíamos mostrado en el evento de Universal. Y ahora les vamos a mostrar la línea American Girl. Y ahora una nueva propiedad para Mega llega con las muñecas de Monster High. Ahora tenemos Mega Monster High. Que eso en un momento más se los vamos a mostrar. Ahí está, ahora sí, Jumpin'. Tenemos Willy Wishers. Primero están Willy Wishers y ahora aquí está de Barbie Dreamtopia o Sueñotopia. Y allá arriba están las Monster High. Tenemos aquí Destiny primero, Mega Constructs, llegando a Destiny, a la zona de videojuegos. Y acá abajo podrán ver la línea de Call of Duty. Y vean qué detalle, están se están superando cada vez más. De este lado tenemos las Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles de Nickelodeon. ¿Ya viste esta tortuga niña emulando a Skeletor? De la línea Shimmer and Shine, que estos ya los habíamos visto del otro lado. Aquí están los Megablocks. También están los de Thomas y Amigos, que también ya nos habían mostrado hace no mucho. Y bueno, de series de Fisher-Price, Little People, aquí están. Y a ver qué hay del lado derecho. No más. Vamos a ver otra de las construcciones de Mega, con más de mi villano favorito. Y ahora, vénganse para acá. Porque tenemos Willy Wishers para mostrarles ahora. Una vez más Mattel demostrando la diversidad. Ahora con su línea de Willy Wishers. Aquí representamos a todas las chicas, donde sea, y son las American Girl. Estas son las American Girl. Ahora sí, estamos aquí con Willy Wishers de Mega. Playsets, las nuevas muñecas. Aquí están presentando a Gabriela McBride. Parece que es una chica muy en onda de acá de Nueva York. Tenemos a Tini Grant y su banda musical. Y ahora está Monster High con una versión bastante grande de The Gorgeous Ghoul. Y bueno, aquí tenemos los Megas, las nuevas figuras en escala pequeña. Modelos de hadas de Monster High. Las aventuras del Ghoul Squad. Aquí tenemos Monster Family. Otra de las series de Monster High. Y aquí atrás, porque vamos con ellas, que están acá atrás, que es Cucu Marayuko. Hi. Very well. Can you talk to us about Cucu?
Cucu Harajuku?
Yes.
It's a brand new music-driven animated series from Gwen Stefani. It's on Nickelodeon in its first season right now, and we've been greenlit for a second season, which is really exciting. And this is the HJ5. There's G in the front, love, angel, music, and baby on the far right. And the overall idea is to inspire girls to express themselves through fashion. And this is Gwen's take on Harajuku style street fashion. My favorite would have to be that lovely little fashion pack of sushi in the very front on the right-hand side. And all of the fashion packs, as well as the dolls, come with a fun little customizable accessory for girl.
Thank you very much.
Sure.
Great. Están muy bonitas. Y bueno, ahora sí, vamos a ver si podemos colarnos al a mostrarles DC Superhero Girls, que están, eso es lo que sería su serie 3 actualmente. Y tenemos personajes nuevos. Tenemos a Frost y Starfire como personajes nuevos. Y hay nuevos vestuarios con las chicas normales. Por ejemplo, podrán ver esos de allá. Son vestuarios nuevos, ahora como traje de gala. Con con cara, con Diana. Y ahora tenemos un nuevo playset. Que es el vehículo para ellas. Como su vehículo de acción de base. Y aquí están las figuras un poco más cortas. Y esta particularmente de Batgirl, que tiene el cambio de ropa con su vehículo. Y bueno, pues estas muñecas se ganaron el premio Totti al juguete del año, a la figura de acción del año. Ahí está, ahí pueden ver reflejado el Totti. Esta Mujer Halcón es un personaje nuevo. Katana no había estado disponible en este formato. Y tenemos ahora este playset con Diana y su motocicleta. Obviamente la base, su castillo. Y esto es Superhero High. Superhero Girls, perdóname. Bueno, acá que hay. La serie de Disney. Mickey and the Road Racers, the Mini, y Linea Cars. Tenemos un nuevo Rayo McQueen, de Cars 3. Esto es lo que se puede mostrar apenas de lo que va a ser Cars 3. Este dice Tech Touch, debe tener alguna peculiaridad si lo tocas. Pero por lo menos podemos ver que Rayo McQueen en lo que sería la defensa tiene como goma. Yo creo que es resistente a los golpes. Y bueno, está una nueva versión. Ahora Toy Story. Tenemos nuevas figuras. Un nuevo Buzz Lightyear. Y ahora vamos con Minecraft. Que esto siempre será muy bien recibido. Y ahora, bueno, de la nueva película de Fast and the Furious, mostramos la línea diecast de las figuras de los carros. Esto ya lo habíamos mostrado en otra edición, pero nuevamente aquí lo tenemos. Porque están muy bonitos. Nuevos playsets. Well. El nuevo carro de Dominic Toretto, que les recordamos, presenta dos tipos de llanta. Una para hacer derrapes y otro para andar normal. Y además dispara cohetes y puedes jugar con tu app y muchas cosas. Y esos son los stunt, los cohetes para hacer proezas, donde puedes hacer que los personajes pasen de un lado a otro apretando un botón. Son metálicos y los cofres de los carros son magnéticos para que puedan detenerse con ellos. Y ahora lo que muchos están esperando, aquí está lo de la WW, lo del Raw. Tenemos el nuevo ring, nuevas figuras. Nuevos accesorios, los cinturones. Y ahí hay una placa que felicita a Mattel por ser el juguete número uno en ventas en los Estados Unidos con la línea WWE de 7 pulgadas. Estamos viendo los nuevos rings. Continuamos ahora con la línea Kamigami.
Like $49, that's crazy.
What is Kamigami?
Kamigami is a building.
Es un robot que tú puedes construir tú mismo. How does it work?
Okay, so how it works is, oh, thank you so much. Hold
thank
on.
You, that was fun.
Hey, thank you. Let me get set up for this, my friend. Okay. Okay, all right. So, what we realized with robotics is that they're really easy to build, or they're quite difficult, or they're already built for you. What Kamigami does, it makes the building process easy yet rewardable. It's made out of this bendable, foldable plastic, and you end up building whatever character you are, and you end up building the case that holds the circuit board that ends up being the legs, right? The only thing that you don't build is this circuit board. This is how it comes. Once you build, you have this cute little robot, right? And it's bendable, foldable plastic. One thing you don't have to worry about is it falling on the floor. Like, it's okay if it falls and it takes time. Once you build it, you get to play with it. And so right now, this is in battle mode. And so there's a sensor on the back and in the front. And say, since no one's playing with me, so say that I am playing with someone, and he may want to get this. If I'm playing with someone, and I shoot you, you can program it to have a certain reaction. So they interact with each other, so if you want to have a sad turn while I'm playing, you can. Since you're disabled, all you have to do is press that X, and then you're going to go back into the new game. And then you're good to go. And now if you want to, you want to try and get me. And so, I was disabled as well. But you know what, if I don't want to be disabled when this happens, I just go into the game, I edit, when robot receives 01 from any direction, I don't want to be disabled, so all I have to do is delete it. But to be fair, we're going to make sure that I add, throughout all of the actions that I could have, I'm going to make sure my disabled joystick is on. Yeah, it's 30 minutes of playtime, 15 minutes of charge. And another fun thing is if you're just driving around and you just want to be in free drive, you can change the color of the eyes. That's another thing that you can do, and you can have just pre-programmed moves. And they're also like super fun. They're just fun to drive. You have any questions?
Is this available now? When is it going to be available?
We're going to be releasing it in the fall.
Okay, and suggested retail price?
It's going to be
$49.99. And will the kit will have
the
designs or just one?
You're going to come with one, but the sleeves are going to be available to purchase. All you have to do with these guys is you just pop them off, and then you'll be able to pop another one on. Mm-hmm. So if I want to be a ladybug one day, that's totally fine, but then I can be a scorpion the next.
All right. Okay, thank you very much.
Hey, you're very welcome.
Bueno, pues estas son nuevas figuras. Y bueno, pues ya los conocemos, los Viewmasters. Ahora viene uno nuevo, que es el diseño completo de Batman. Aunque el paquete ya está disponible en tiendas, el The Animated Series. Pero aquí están, que llamen más la atención, el de Masters of the Universe y el de Batman The Animated Series. Y entonces, pues es el Viewmaster que ya les hemos mostrado actualmente, que este funciona con con todos los, y bueno, no creo que alcancen a ver, pero aquí se está jugando el de He-Man. Y tiene muchas cosas que hacer. Y que se llama Block Cells, Este es para que tú crees su propio videojuego. Este es el diseño del personaje y esta es la plataforma que tenemos. Y sería bueno que alguien nos platicara sobre voxels. A ver, vamos a ver si consigo a alguien.
For voxels?
Yeah, this kind of interested me.
We saw this product around this time last year. We partnered with Pixel Press, and it's just a wonderful game. It's a way that kids can learn how to code in a way using colored blocks. So we all know kids love blocks, and they know how to play with blocks, but not every kid knows how to code. So this is a way that they teach them. So green is ground, blue is water. If you pretend that you're a character, I'm gonna jump over here. Avoid the water, collect all my coins, avoid the lava, and I'm going to continue on. After you build one of your rooms, you capture it within the app that's provided within the game, and then you get to build your world. So the coins were already taken from somebody, but I can still shoot, and I can blow that up, and then I'm going to jump over to avoid the lava. Oh no, I didn't make it, but that's okay. And the reason why he falls through is because this room only consists of one of these in your video game. So you can have a video game, you can have this room 169 times. Another thing that we like to show is that you can also capture characters. If you look over here, that guy is that guy with the additions that people have left behind. It's very wonderful. We love that it takes kids' eyes off the screen because we know the nature of video games, like, usually has them just staring at a screen. And it allows them to have more agency about how their game looks.
Oh, it's awesome. And
yeah.
Now, you say this is already available?
Yeah, we saw this product around this time last year, and then within 6 months, we were sending it out to retailers.
Okay. And this is about how many, how much?
How much? $49.99.
$49.99. Well, thank you very much.
Hey, you're welcome.
Luxus es una buena nueva versión. Y pues esto fue todo el recorrido que estamos haciendo. Todo esto es el booth de Mattel aquí en Toy Fair, y pues muchas gracias por habernos acompañado. Aquí seguiremos mostrando cosas más de Toy Fair, así que no se despeguen de juegos, juguetes y coleccionables.